This year's WWDC keynote was all about the upgrades. With VR and immersive experiences proving that the future of computers means more power, processing, and speed, Apple updated both hardware and software to make room for a very visual, content-heavy future. The event was broken down by device category into six major updates, but let's talk hardware first. Apple's long-rumored Amazon Echo competitor is real, and it's called the HomePod. The device is a pill-shaped circular speaker. The HomePod costs $349 and is focused on music first rather than Siri, but of course it does that too. Macs, MacBooks, and MacBook Pros all got a performance boost. The machines are getting a new Kaby Lake processor and faster solid-state hard drives. Then there's a new iMac Pro. It's an all-in-one workstation that has more or less the same look and feel as the 27-inch iMac, but you get an Intel Xeon processor, and depending on how much you love cores, you get 8, 10, or 18 of them. Before you get too excited about the pure power of this machine, you should know that it has a $4,999 price tag. That said, it does look pretty epic, and it has ports, so many ports. Ignored on stage today, the MacBook Air is still alive, but is the only machine to not get an update. With the cost of the 13-inch MacBook Pro dropping down to $1,299, it will be interesting to see if the Air sticks around. The other affordable option, the iPad Mini, also didn't get any updates, meaning the iPad Mini 4 is probably going to be the last iPad Mini ever. Instead, Apple is running full steam ahead with the iPad Pro line, announcing a 10.5-inch model that weighs in at about a pound. Upgrades to the new iPad Pro include a True Tone display, which is now 50% brighter, a 120Hz refresh rate dubbed ProMotion that makes interacting with content on the tablet more responsive, and support for a full on-screen keyboard. Starting at 64 gigs of memory, the new iPad Pro costs $649 for the 10.5-inch or $799 for the 13-inch. Moving on to the watch, there was no hardware news, but watchOS 4 is available for developer preview now and will roll out this fall. Updates mostly focus on surfacing the information you need in a more organized and intelligent way, making the most of the watch's small screen. On the topic of OS, Sierra has been replaced by High Sierra. On the new OS, the built-in mail app now uses less space for storing your mail. Photos received a major update that uses machine learning to better recognize faces and improve sorting. Upgrades to Safari will make surfing the web faster, and cool features like blocking autoplay on videos and intelligent tracking prevention will make using the browser a lot more secure. Other new OS features include the ability for apps to open in new windows as tabs, support for Apple Pay on the desktop, hands-free unlock with the help of a nearby Apple Watch, as well as updates to virtually all default apps. Apple also announced iOS 11. With iOS 11, Siri is getting better at understanding context, your interest, and more. You can now ask for translations using Siri, starting with Chinese, French, German, Italian, and Spanish. Also new, the control center looks completely different and features a ton of buttons, reducing the need to swap between multiple tabs. Apple's Live Photos is becoming more powerful in iOS 11 with the introduction of a series of editing tools and effects. The updated camera app will also support H.265, which lets you shoot better quality video with a smaller file size. The App Store is getting a brand new design. Based on the demo, there will be a ton of text, images, and context in general. It just looks cleaner with a better layout and less taps. In an interesting twist, Apple announced some iPad-specific iOS 11 features that focus on productivity and further blur the difference between iOS and macOS. Specifically, iOS 11 brings drag and drop, Windows, and a file system to the iPad. On to music. Apple Music hit 27 million paid subscribers, added the MusicKit API, and social listening. This will really shine with the new AirPlay 2, which allows for multi-room synchronized streaming support and integration with HomeKit. Amazon Prime Video is coming to Apple TV. tvOS launched with a handful of partners, which it has since expanded to roughly 50. And that about covers it. There are a ton of specs and new upgrades to both hardware and software, but honestly, even Apple realized that there was just too many numbers to rattle off and opted for more visual demos instead. For full coverage of Apple's WWDC keynote, visit TechCrunch.com.